to integralcalc.com. We're going to be doing a bunch of infinite series problems today. The first one is 1 plus e to the negative 1 plus e to the negative 2 plus e to the negative 3 plus dot dot dot. It's the series that we're given. The problem asks us to determine whether or not this infinite series converges or diverges, and if it does converge, to find the sum of the series. So given that, if that's what the question asks us to do, the formula that we can use for that kind of problem is the following. This notation is called summation notation. This weird E thing is the symbolizes the sum. It just means the sum of this series here when the first value of k is 0 and going on into infinity. So the formula, nonetheless, has three parts. This is the first part. Second part, this formula is much longer than this, but I just abbreviate it with these three parts because they're really the only things you need to remember. And then so this is the first part, the second part, and the third part. I've separated them with semicolons, which I think I'm going to go ahead and take away because it's kind of harder to see. So this is the formula. I already explained the first part, but basically if your series fits into this form, meaning if you can apply this x to the k to your series, if your series takes this form, then you have your x right here. If the absolute value of x is less than 1, then your series converges, and it converges to this value, x being the same here as it is in both of these. If it's greater than or equal to 1, the absolute value of x greater than or equal to 1, then you have a divergent series, and you don't even need to worry about this third step. So basically what we need to do, given that this is a three-part formula, is determine first whether or not our series takes this form. If it does, then to determine whether or not the absolute value of x is less than 1. If it does, we know it converges, and then we would need to proceed to this third step to find the sum of the series. So, three parts, like I said. The first being, does our series fit this form here? The way that the easiest way I find to determine this, if your series already begins with 1, meaning the first term is 1, like we have in our series here, we have 1 and then plus a series of e's and exponents. If the first term is 1, I don't know, maybe 90% of the time, a lot of the time, this term right here is going to be your, is going to be x. Is exactly equal to x, and you're done and you don't have to go any farther. We'll show you how you can prove that it's x, but this, it's usually the second term, and that includes the sign here. So if, you know, if it's positive sign, it doesn't matter so much, but if this were a negative sign, x would be negative e to the negative 1, and you'd need to include that sign. So since the series starts with 1, I'm going to guess that this whole term, e to the negative 1, is our x term. The way that we can double check to make sure that it is the following. Remember how I said that this notation means that the first value of k will be 0? Well, you can imagine, if the first value of k is 0 and we're going on to infinity, then this series looks like the following. X to the 0 plus x to the 1 plus x to the 2 plus x to the 3 plus dot 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 forever. X to the 0, right, is 1, because anything raised to the 0 power is 1. So that's kind of why this 1 here at the beginning of the series is sort of a dead giveaway, because, and if the first value of k is 0 and this is a 1, then anything to the 0 power, and that being the first term in the series, is equal to 1, so you know you're kind of already set up. But let's go ahead and double check. So now, And realize, too, that x to the 1, right, is the same thing as x, which is why this second term here, these are going to correspond here. This 1, this second term, this x, and what we're going to get here, this third term, x squared, and the third term we're going to get here. So x to the 1 is the same thing as x, which is why this second term here, right after the 1, is our x term. But let's go ahead and double check this anyway. So this would be, right, we said e to the negative 1 was our x, so we'd have e to the negative 1 and then to the 1 plus x again is e to the negative 1 to the 2 plus again e to the negative 1 this time to the 3 plus dot dot dot. Okay, so if our x term is e to the negative 1, then this is what our series looks like. And does this series match this series? Well, if we simplify, we can see that it does, in fact, because we get e to the negative 1. When you have one exponent raised to another exponent, all you do is multiply them together. So since this is negative 1 squared, that's simply the 2 multiplied together, and you get negative 2. So e to the negative 2 plus e negative 1 times 3 is negative 3 plus dot dot dot. And you can see that this series down here is matching up exactly to this series, which means that we did in fact pick the correct x value of x here. We did that correctly, and our x value is e to the negative 1. So now that we've determined our x value, that's really all we needed to do. We needed to figure out whether or not our series took this form. We had to figure out what x was. Since 1 was the first term in the series, I predicted that this second term here would be our x term, because it almost always is when the series starts with 1. And then I just double-checked. This is the form that the series takes based on this formula. So I plugged our x term into this form here, simplified, and yes, they do match, which means that our series does take this form, and our x term is e to the negative 1. So, since x is e to the negative 1, so our series will look like this. Infinity k equals 0, and we'll have e to the negative 1 to the k. So that is our series. Now we need to determine whether or not the series converges or diverges. So what we go ahead and do is we say the absolute value of our x, which is e to the negative 1. And now we do that on our calculator. So when you're plugging this into your calculator, make sure that you plug it in like this. E and then parentheses to the negative 1, because, and this, of course, you'll have a little caret like that. So if I plug it into my calculator, negative 1, I get 0.3678. If we do second e to the negative 1. Yeah, okay, so it does end up being the same thing. You don't technically need the parentheses, but I think it's a good practice to have. Since you have the negative sign in there, you just want to make sure that it's included in the right way. But anyway, this is the value you get when you plug in e to the negative 1. So we're looking at the absolute value of 0.3678. Absolute value basically just means take the positive value of whatever's inside these vertical brackets here. So if this had been negative 2, absolute value of negative 2 is 2, because we just make it positive, even if it's a negative. Since our value is already positive, then absolute value doesn't really apply. This ends up being the same thing. It's just 0.3678. Since 0.3678 is less than 1, that does mean that our series converges. Remember that if this value is greater than or equal to 1, that our series diverges. So we've determined that the series does converge, and they asked us to determine the sum if the series did converge. So let's go ahead and use the third part of our equation here to determine the sum. So remember that x here, we're using e to the negative 1. So our sum would be 1 over 1 minus e to the negative 1. So I'm going to go ahead and do some simplification here. This would be the same as 1 over 1 minus, since this is e to the negative 1, that's the same thing as 1 over e. You can, this e to the negative 1 here is in the numerator, technically, of its own term. We moved it to the denominator by putting 1 over it, which means we can change this negative 1 to a positive 1 right here. Of course, we didn't write it because it's redundant. We never write anything to the power of 1. So so that this 1 over e is the same thing as e to the negative 1. So that's some simplification. Then I'm going to go ahead and change this 1 to e over e, right, which is the same thing as 1, so that I can combine these two fractions on the bottom. So what I'll end up having is 1 over, and since I have e in the denominator of both of these fractions, I can combine them and say e minus 1 over e is my denominator here. Now, since I have 1 divided by a fraction, I can flip this fraction over on itself and multiply these together. So instead of this divided by this, I can do this divided by, or this multiplied by the inverse of this fraction here. So this is the same thing as 1 times e over e minus 1, which means that 1 can just go away, obviously. And we're left with e over e minus 1. So this is the cleanest way to leave your final answer, but if you want to convert to a decimal, or if you have a multiple choice exam that maybe only gives you decimals, then you would, of course, do, I would do the bottom first. I would do second e to the 1, get that answer, subtract 1 from that, and then do second e to the 1 divided by answer, and the decimal value of that ends up being 1.5819. So either of these, they're equivalent, obviously, are correct. But this is the cleaner way to leave your answer. So once you get here, I would go ahead and stop. So again, find out whether the series is in this form, determine what your x is, apply this formula to see whether or not it converges or diverges, convergent being when the absolute value of x is less than 1, and then since it does converge, find its sum using this formula here, just some quick algebraic simplification, and that's your final answer. Thanks, guys!